So let's use GBIF as an example of error flagging. GBIF, by the internal structure and the way of being, can't and allowed to modify the original information. So what they do in order to provide a level of higher level of quality is to flag the errors that appear in the data. So we as users, when we go to GBIF and download the data, by using the data portal, we have to accept some data usage terms, which the term of the need to cite the data is there on the data usage terms. And the publishers have to sign a data sharing agreement, which says GBIF secretariat, the central node of GBIF, the one that coordinates everything, may achieve a copy, may store a copy of the data, and serve it, serve full or partial data. How do they know which data to serve and which data not to serve? Because this is based on the error flagging techniques that we apply. How do they detect the issues to know which records show and which records not show? They have some really good processing routines that search for the most common issues. And when an error is detected, it's flagged because they cannot improve it. So the flags, these flags, these error flags, are used to alert both users and owners of the existence of problems in the data. Let's see, for example, if we make a search like the ones that we made at the beginning of the session, we might have something like this, which is a table of the available records for that search. Here, there's a field called coordinates, which have coordinates of that record, of those records. But below the coordinates, there's a little piece of text that says coordinates for outside specified country, territory, or island. That means coordinates are given, country is given, but they do not match. We map the coordinates, they won't fall in the specified country. That's a perfect example of error flag. They do not modify the coordinates because they're not allowed to do so, but they alert the user, if you want high quality data, you shouldn't use this code, or at least you should find your way to improve. In the example we have seen, Kenya records. In the text block here, there are some numbers. The first of them here is the number of records with coordinates in the collection. The second number is the number of records shown in the map. They do not match. There are 146 records that have coordinates but do not fall in the map. So this is what GBIF mean by serving partial data. They are not giving all the available information because some records are clearly wrong. And this is based on the previous flag we have seen. So what happens when errors are flagged? How do we proceed, or how should the ideal path continue? First of all, flags or annotations should reach the original publisher. Owner of the data should be aware that there are some issues with their records because he or she is the only one who can solve the issues at the source. The original publisher is the only person or persons that have the ability to correct their information. So once the data is correct, because they have knowledge of the issues and they are made some cleaning processes. A new version of the data is deployed. GBIF re-indexes everything, updates the caching, and then the issues that we have seen previously won't appear anymore. And this has happened often. In the example we have seen of the transposition, what I've shown you is an old version of that collection. Somewhere in 2009, they were aware of this problem, and they solved it. They changed the coordinates again, and then it was solved. But this is something the publisher had to do. We could tell them, you have this thing wrong, but they are the ones that have to change. So the key factor here, and one bottleneck, is the awareness and the implication of data owners. Some of the owners are really into the data quality thing, and they take care of the data, but some of us don't. Happen to me to report issues to the regional collections, but they just ignore because they don't understand what's wrong. They do not want to do anything more with the data. So in these cases, without the owners having been aware of it, the process of flagging loses its sense. Because we cannot modify it, they don't want to modify it, and they are not able to modify it. So the error can last there forever. So error flagging itself can be applied to several data storage formats. And each format has its own requirements. We are going to focus on the spreadsheet, on how to flag errors using spreadsheets, such as the LibreOffice, Google spreadsheets, Google Refine, Microsoft Office, all this kind of visual. And why? Because spreadsheets, as you may have noticed, are the most comfortable way of managing data. They're not the most powerful, but they are really comfortable. Because they allow for a semi-structured visual management of information. Data is organized in rows and columns, but they are not determined how many specific type of information. We don't have to say, this column will have a number. So if there's text, which is clearly wrong, it's easy to manage that. And we have also the ability to plot the records, to make visualizations of the records that can help in, not in flagging, but in getting clues on how to flag the records. And second, do calculations inside cells. So some of the most common operations with error flagging in spreadsheets are sorting. For example, we can sort a column and see the minimum and maximum values to see if they fall outside the accepted boundary. If we, for example, sort the month field, we can see if there are numbers below 1 or above 12. There's a better way to do this, and it's the use of filters. Filtering makes an internal sort and takes the distinct values that appear in the column. So for example, if we make a filter on the kingdom field, we can see all the different values that appear, which will be very few. And in this case, for example, we might not see that here says animalia, which is okay, but metaphor, which is not the standard way a tool that most spreadsheets have is the conditional formatting. It's to give a specific format to a cell or column based on the content of that cell or column. So if we take the kingdom example, we can make a conditional formatting that if the field contains the term animalia, the cell is colored in green. Or not colored at all, if we don't want to see the triggers that are okay. But if the cell has the value metasol, then we can make it, we can highlight it by putting a red background so that visually it helps in detecting which records are wrong. Most spreadsheets also allow for the use of control vocabulary. We can define a list of entries, we can provide a list of cells with certain key values, and make some columns allow only these values. So if you introduce another different value, it won't allow you to do so. This is very useful for terms, for double code terms, which are recommended to use a control vocabulary, such as the basis of record. We can plot the records to see it visually, to detect some of the issues. Not to flag them, but for example, by taking the gear column, can plot it and see that the minimum gear is 1700, which is a really dubious